So hello students, welcome to the fourth session of chapter 10, reaching the age of adolescence, class 8. Today we will learn that the changes which occur at adolescence, they are controlled by the chemical substances called hormones. Hormones are actually the secretions which are secreted from the endocrine glands. And these endocrine glands are actually glands of ductless glands, and they secrete chemical substances called hormones, which are directly poured into the blood. As we are studying about adolescence, so we are more concerned about the sex hormones or the hormones which are produced by the reproductive organs on the onset of puberty. So in boys, the reproductive organs, testes, begin to release male hormone or testosterone. They help or they cause development of secondary sexual characters in boys, which we have already studied in previous sessions. In girls, the ovaries begin to produce the female hormone or estrogen, which makes the breast develop, and the milk secreting glands, they develop inside, or mammary glands develop inside the breast. The production of these hormones is under the control of another hormone in endocrine gland itself, and it is known as pituitary. It is attached to the brain. This is pituitary shown in the diagram. These are testes and these are ovaries. This is a diagram to show the endocrine glands only. The onset of puberty is controlled. All the changes that takes place on the onset of puberty, they are under the control of these hormones. Hormones from puberty stimulate testes and ovaries to release testosterone in male and estrogen in female, and they are released in the bloodstream, and then they reach those parts, that is the target site, reach the different parts of the body, and they, after reaching different parts of the body, they stimulate changes in those parts of the body. Now we will study the other hormones which are produced by the endocrine glands, which are not related to the reproductive organs. We will study few other hormones also. So in this slide I have shown about the endocrine glands, which are ductless glands, and actually these are the hormones are actually the chemical messengers which carry messages to particular organ or tissue through the bloodstream. These glands control growth, development, metabolism and reproduction. Endocrine glands secrete hormones in response to external and internal stimuli. Okay, so the most important gland is the master gland. It is pituitary. It is attached to the brain and it secretes growth hormone. The function of the growth hormone is to regulate growth and controls the functioning of the other endocrine glands. Another endocrine gland is known as thyroid, which is situated in the neck region, and it secretes a hormone called thyroxine. It controls the metabolism rate and also brings about balanced growth. Another hormone is known as adrenaline hormone, which is secreted by adrenal adrenal glands are situated on the top of the kidney. Okay, now these glands produces adrenaline glands, which is actually the stress hormone, or it prepares our body for emergency. Then pancreas is also an endocrine gland shown in the figure also. It secretes a hormone called insulin, and it controls the glucose level or the sugar level of the blood. Then I have already told you about the testes and ovaries. Now let us study two important diseases which are caused by the deficiency of the secretion of these endocrine glands. For example, this disease is called goiter. In Hindi it is known as ghenga rog, and it is the disease where the deficiency of a hormone called thyroxin is the cause, and this thyroxin hormone is released by the thyroid gland, which is situated in the neck region. So whenever there is deficiency of thyroxin hormone, it causes a disease called goiter. And for the proper secretion of the thyroxin, a person should take iodine rich diet. And the second disease is diabetes, commonly known as sugar. So increase in the level of sugar in blood is known as diabetes, and it is controlled by an insulin hormone secreted by pancreas, which is an endocrine gland. Okay, then today we will also learn about a very interesting topic, which is known as metamorphosis, and it is actually a very amazing natural process which exists in our nature. You must have wondered even how a caterpillar turns into a beautiful butterfly. So this ugly caterpillar has to pass to the various stages. Earlier it is egg, from egg it larva is emerged, and then it converts into pupa, and then a beautiful butterfly is created. And this is actually a complete transformation, or we can say drastic transformation, of an egg into a beautiful butterfly. In frog also, the eggs, they first are converted into tadpole, then larger tadpole, and then adult tadpole. The adult frog lays eggs. The eggs grow into tadpole, which is divided into early and late tadpole. The late tadpole then grows into adult frog. The larva into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. And in insect, this metamorphosis is controlled by insect hormone, whereas in frog it is controlled by thyroxin hormone. Thyroxin, as I have told you, it is the hormone produced by the thyroid gland. Thyroxin production actually requires the presence of iodine in water. If the water in which the tadpoles are growing doesn't contain sufficient iodine, the tadpole can't become adults. So this is all about today's session. So in the next session, that will be our last session, we will learn about the nutritional needs of an adolescent. So thank you and stay tuned for the next session.